Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily reduce your JPEG image sizes down using a free program called Gimp. It's really quick to do, so check it out. Hey everyone, it's Ken here from Northern Viking Everyday, and if you are new to this channel, it is all about reviews and how-tos, so make sure you click that subscribe button so you don't miss out on upcoming videos. Today we're going to be showing you how to reduce the file size of your JPEG images. It's super easy to do, it's quick, and it's free. We're going to be using a program called Gimp today. It's an image manipulation program, and again, it's totally free. We'll show you where you can get that in just a moment. If you're like me, I create YouTube videos and I upload custom thumbnails, and those can't be over 2 megabytes in size. So I need to reduce the size of my thumbnails, or maybe you're using these images for different purposes and you just need smaller file sizes. That's what we're going to be teaching you today. So let's head on over to my desktop and show you how this is done. So if you don't already have GIMP on your computer, it is on my highly recommended list that every computer should have on it. It's totally free and it's amazing software that you can use to manipulate your pictures. It's similar to Photoshop, but again, it's totally free. So if you go to gimp.org, you can download it here for free. There's an orange download button at the top, or right at the very top here, you can click download and you can click on the downloads here. It's available for Linux, Mac, and Windows. So go ahead and install that. I've already got it installed on my computer. It's this little character dude with a paintbrush in his mouth. I am gonna go ahead and open up the software. And again, with this software, you can add text, you can change colors, you can rotate things just as you would in Photoshop. But again, it's slightly different, but a great program to have. So now I've got this loaded up. We're not going to be adjusting the image in any way. I've already got it where I want it to be, but we do need to load the image in here. So there's a couple ways to do that. The first would be to click File up here in the top left-hand corner. And come down to the third option here, it says open, or you could click Control O to open. When I click on that, it's gonna bring up a menu where I can search for the file. And the file I'm using is actually on my desktop, so I'm gonna just click on desktop, and it is the one here called GoPro Thumbnail. And you can see right here, it says it's 2.8 megabytes in size. We wanna reduce that under 2 megabytes in order for me to upload it to YouTube. So that's the first way. I could click on that and hit open to open it. To be honest, the fastest way that I do this almost every time is I actually just drag and drop the image. So I've got it right here on my desktop, and I'm gonna drag it into the middle of GIMP, and it pulls the image right into GIMP. So I've got that image open here, and again, this was a thumbnail that I made for a previous video that we're working with today. All right, so I've got my image in here, and now we need to reduce it from that 2.8 megabytes down to under 2 megabytes, or maybe you want to go smaller than that, you can do that as well. So up in the top left-hand corner, there is the file button again. We're gonna just click on that, and we're gonna scroll down here right in the middle. It says export as. So you could also use the shortcut Shift Control E or click export as. Now Shift Control E is the Windows shortcut. If you're using a Mac, I'm not sure what that is. Maybe someone could write it in the comment section below if you know what the shortcut is for Mac or Linux. But let's click on export as, and you can see it's got the same file name up here at the top. So the name is goprothumbnail.jpg. We're gonna select where we wanna put it. So I'm gonna just click desktop so it goes to my desktop. But I don't actually want it to overwrite my existing file, or maybe I do. If I do want it to overwrite my existing file, I'd leave the file name exactly the same as it is. But if I do want to have two files there, I'm gonna add to this file name. So I'm gonna just type in resize here so I know that that's the one. So now it's resize goprothumbnail.jpg. I've got the file name, I've got the location. Now we're just gonna go ahead and click export right down here at the bottom. And a new window is gonna pop up. You can see this window here, and it's got a couple things that we need to look at. It's got the quality at 95%, but we don't know how big this file is or how big we're gonna make it yet. So there's this little box here that says show preview in image window. And if I click that right there, it's gonna say calculating file size. And you can see that as it is right now at quality of 95, it's 3 megabytes in size. So if I want to, if I go up to 100, it's calculating again. That file is going to be saved at 5.4 megabytes. But again, in my situation, I'm trying to get it under 2 megabytes. So let's lower that down. So 94, 93, go down maybe 89. 89 is 2 megabytes exactly. I want to go just under to make sure it works. So 88 is 1.9 megabytes. That's perfect for what I need. If you're looking for something really small, maybe you, let me just type in 75 here. And that would be 1.1 megabytes. So I'm going to go back to 88, just so we're at 1.9. And now I'm just going to go ahead and click export right here. And it is exporting that file. And if I just shrink this down, you're going to see that I have a new file on my desktop here. So I've got the original one and the new resized GoPro thumbnail right here. And when I hover over it, you can see it is 1.8 megabytes in size. So it's exactly what I need to upload it to YouTube for my thumbnail. So I hope this tutorial was able to help you out in reducing the size of your JPEG images using GIMP. If it did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Also remember to subscribe to Northern Viking Every Day because I've got tons of videos coming up that I would love to share with you. Thanks so much for watching today and take care.